Good morning. 2020 Form 45 CC2, Depreciation and Amortization. How to calculate the depreciation deduction for an asset you remove from your business before the end of its recovery years. So assuming you place an asset in your business, you use it in your business, and you took the regular depreciation on it, and then at some point you took it out of service, you have to stop depreciating that asset. But how do you calculate the depreciation deduction for that last year that you use it in your business? So if you remove an asset early out of your business, there are a few steps you will follow. So you cannot claim, for sure, you cannot claim the full depreciation deduction for that year. So you will calculate the depreciation deduction that you will have claimed that year if the asset was not removed from service. And you'll find about the convention you use to depreciate the asset. That's why having a record of the asset you depreciate can be helpful. If you keep a record of your depreciation of your asset in depreciation spreadsheet, you'll be able to easily locate the information needed. Next, you'll calculate the partial depreciation deduction. You'll know the date the asset was removed from business as well. So it's good to take note of those information. So first option, half year convention. So if the convention you use to depreciate the asset was a half year convention, let's see, we can pull an example here, an example of a laptop. If you use a half year convention, you take the depreciation you're supposed to take that year divided by 2 to calculate the partial depreciation deduction for the assets that you remove from service. And if we go back to this depreciation spreadsheet, for the laptop, if we assume that you use half year convention, you use it and depreciate it year 1, year 2, is laptop is a 5 year, has a 5 year recovery period. Therefore, you depreciate in 6 years, and year 4, you took it out of service. So the depreciation you'll have claimed, therefore you'll stop depreciating it, but you'll claim a depreciation deduction for that year 4. And the full amount that you could have claimed in year 4 is $115.20 in our example of $1,000 worth of a laptop placed in service in 2020. So you are not going to claim that full deduction, but you divide it by 2 to find the depreciation deduction to report on your business tax. And you are now going to claim the remaining depreciation balance. You will stop depreciating that asset from the moment you remove it off service, and you will claim a partial depreciation deduction for it. So that's the example for half year convention. So for mid month convention, which works for residential rental properties and non-residential real properties. So for mid-month convention, if you remove a residential rental property from service earlier than expected or remove a non-residential real property off service early, you'll take the depreciation deduction that you should have claimed that year multiplied by the number of months the asset was in service during the year that you remove from the business divided by 12 months to find the partial depreciation deduction. So we'll go back to our depreciation spreadsheet and find an example of we can use a non-residential, we can use a rental property. So a rental property, one that you place in service, assuming you place in service way before, you know, 2020, and now in 2000, but let's say it was in service all the way to year 9, and residential rental property, their mid-month convention, and year 9, which will have claimed a full deduction of 3,636 you took it off service, let's say in March. So at the end of March, for instance, so that's 3 months, it was in service for 3 months that year. So you'll take the depreciation deduction for that year you took it off service times the 3 months you have the rental property in service divided by 12. That will give you the depreciation deduction to claim for that year 9 that you are filing the tax return for. And then you'll stop depreciating it after year 9. So that will be the example of mid-month convention. For mid-quarter convention, so an asset that you depreciated using mid-quarter convention, right from the start, you'll took the full year depreciation deduction for the year you took it off service times a certain percentage that IRS has in the publication 946, page 40. So you will multiply it by the percentage that corresponds to that quarter you remove it off service to calculate the partial depreciation. So if you use the assets in your business during first quarter and then you took it out in the first quarter, you will use 12.5%. So we can find the percentage, but we can locate, we can use a desk. So an office desk that we place in service, let's say we place in service before 2020, or in 2020, and let's work going forward in the future, and we use mid-quarter convention. So you're supposed to depreciate it in 8 years. It has 7 year recovery period, but you'll fully recover the cost by year 8. So if you took it off service in year 5, the depreciation deduction for the full year 5 is $502. In our example, you will take that $502 and you'll locate publication 946 for that year, and page 40 is for 2019, but for year 9, I don't know what page that will be, but it's going to be sales or other disposition before the recovery period end session. And if you took it off in the first quarter, so assuming the rates are the same, we are just working with today's rates. So that 502 times 12.5% will give you the depreciation deduction you will claim on your business return for that particular asset. And then you will stop depreciating it for the following years. If you took it off service in quarter two, then you'll use 37.5% times that 502. That's if you took it off service in quarter three, and that will be 62.5% times $502. And if you use it all the way to the fourth quarter and took it off service during any month of the fourth quarter, then you'll use 87.5% or whatever the rates will be in that year for the fourth quarter times $502 to find the depreciation deduction, the partial depreciation deduction that you will claim in year five that you took the assets off service. So if you are using an asset in your business and you took it off early, having a depreciation worksheet PDF that you keep in your file, a depreciation spreadsheet will allow you to find, you know, the information that you use to depreciate the assets and be able to calculate the partial depreciation that you should claim on your assets. And the depreciation spreadsheet will calculate it for you if you enter the right information. The depreciation spreadsheet will calculate it for you, but the depreciation worksheet PDF, you will have to calculate the information yourself and keep it in your business binder for all those assets you depreciate, you use in your business. And pulling the information out, you'll be able to calculate the partial depreciation that you need to claim in your business. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Afiavi Ojune Liberman, creators of Liberman Consulting LLC, YouTube channel, Liberman Consulting LLC. Podcast, ninasoap.com, our blog. We have a free download session, no email is required to access, where you can find form links to form 4562, links to instructions for form 4562, and links to publication 946. You need that publication to calculate the right depreciation rates if you place an asset in business the first year. And once you locate that rate, it's good to just calculate it for all the years. That way, when you are going to file your return, you just pull the depreciation deduction for the year you are filing for and plug it in your business tax return. Thank you so much for your time. We thank you very much for watching our video. Thank you very much, you all that subscribe to our channel, and we thank you very much for all your comments. Thank you for reading our blog. Thank you for listening to our podcast. We have a category on our blog, ninasoap.com, where we have topics about depreciation, and the category is how to depreciate a business asset. We do have videos about depreciation and how to complete form 4562 for 2020 under the playlist 2020 form 4562 depreciation and amortization to help you calculate accurately the depreciation deduction of any asset you place in service during the tax year 2020. Thank you so much for your time. We do have our online store, including liberlabel.com for digital products, liberlabel.com for custom apparels and stationery, liberdownload.com for digital products, including spreadsheet, PDF to help you manage your finances and your business successfully. We have liberoutlet.com for wholesale products and ninassoap.com for natural products, including soap, towels made out of natural fibers. Thank you.